Hi, Sten here. In this video, I want to show you how easy it is to build a website using WordPress. We just take a free domain. First of all, find a name for your website. Save it and continue. Choose a website. And of course, call it the same. Sten's Tests. That would be easy. This is just a test site. And I build it with a free domain from my host. You can choose host and you can buy a domain anywhere. First of all, I choose a name and then I choose a team. There are tons of teams, as you can see, there are more than 2,000 teams. I take one of my favorites because it's the easiest one to use. I haven't done any this page. You will see the video and it's not this team, but this is an easy team. And okay, now I'm ready to build it. Here we are. We are inside our WordPress dashboard, and first of all, we are going to upgrade everything. This is the first part you have to consider doing when you start up, and upgrade everything. And now we're inside the test. This is the broad test. We only have our home and a sample page, and you can see the sample page is just some text WordPress put in to show you have a page. Of course, we deleted the pages and the posts and start all over. This is the first we do. Hello world. Put that into the trash. Delete it permanently. We don't need it and we don't want it on our website. We're gonna create three pages. About page and what is the page about? This is just a test page, so. We call it a test about me page, yes, and the next is we update and upgrade to the next page, and then the test. Let's just this is just a test, and I don't want to put any context in it, and I don't think you need to consider this. This is just how to open it and just to start out. And the last page, it's a private policy page, and this page we're gonna move later on because I don't want it in the main menu. I wanna have it in the footer in the bottom of the page, and we're gonna set it as a static page, but not now. Let's see what we have done up till now. Home, about me, and the test. Home is there's nothing here, so we create a post for this one, add a new post, and we can call it the why testing, I guess so, and add a little bit context on it, and publish it, and you can see you have Grammarly into it. Now we can see why testing, this is a test post, and you can see you have it there. We have everything in the main menu. Going back to the dashboard. We're not going into theme now. If you go to screen option, you can erase a little bit and make it much easier. Let's go to the, and I can show you a little bit more how you can filter your theme if you are brand new to this. But most WordPress users have a theme they like to use. Okay, now we're going to the widget area. I have found a theme. It's a free theme, but it has some widget area. It has a main widget area and a footer head widget area. That means it's in the bottom of the page. We have our menu, and we can erase, put things away, and but here we have to put the sub menu, a custom menu. In the subfolder, and of course press save. Now we're good to go, and then we go to the menus area, and we're going to create our menus. This is our main menu structure, and then we have, you can see we have removed the private policy and set it as a main menu. You can and go to the page, main page, and see how it looks without. And this is the block, and the test would be the front page. Okay, let's take the private policy and create a new menu for it. We can call it menu number 2. That would be the easiest part. Number 2, yes, and create that menu. And we have it now. And then we have some. Nope. And this is not the main menu. And we put the private policy into this menu. That would be the easy part. And save it. Always save. We have one menu. And we can go back to the widget area. And you can see the menu there, custom menu. And we have to select which of the menu we should be in the subfolder. And of course, it's menu number 2. And we have only one page there. And we have saved it and visit site. And you will see this. We have this is clean now. We have the and we have the private policy in the bottom. This is not a theme. This is not something we probably have to use right now. Later on, we can put some tests on. Now we're going to the settings. In general, there's nothing less than we have to erase the tagline. Just erase the tagline and do some call it the tests. I think so. Yes. The test side is safe, of course, and check the time is good. And let's go see what it look like. Now I want to go to the plugins, and we have 2 plugins. We have to activate the all-in-one SEO activated, and there's some work we can do in there. Let's go to the general setting. Nothing to here yet, but later on we can go and do something. I wanna take a new team or a new plugin called Spam Shield because we don't want spam in our comments. This is the easiest part. Yes, and as you can see, it's one of the. It's really a great plugin to have to control your spam folder and control if anyone spam you. So let's activate it and install it and go and activate the last plugins. The image optimizer, I haven't done anything about that yet, but activate the plugins and activate Spam Shield. And I think that's it. If you do that, then you're quick to go. Now we can go back to the dashboard or post, and we can make a category for the test. Let's go in and edit it. You can always edit your post when you have done. This is just for a test, and this would not be. A public erase it after, but as you can see, I've called just a test the category for this post, and that's it. You can choose if you want a static say page like I do, or I just want the post. But this is definitely up to you, and. I would show you a little bit more in the next video how we can set everything up. Okay, thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoyed the video.